Welcome back to Trends and Friends. I'm joined by Laura Dermeyer, Dia Young-Smith, and of course we've got Zoe Perkypile. And you guys are all going to be putting on a spectacular classic, something you always read as a child, but you don't always get to relive as an adult, and you all are giving us the opportunity to do so. Charlotte's Web is going to be coming up very soon, so first and foremost, for someone who doesn't know, tell us a little bit about Charlotte's Web and why people should come out.
Charlotte's Web is a classic children's tale about a young pig named Wilbur who is afraid of becoming bacon, and he meets a spider whose name is Charlotte, and she comes up with a plan to keep him alive by writing words in her web.
Okay. And of course, we have Charlotte and Wilbur here with us today. Yes. Tell us a little bit about Charlotte's character.
Charlotte is a very motherly character. She's somebody who illustrates the value of friendship and taking care of your community. And it's in a most unlikely package because, as Wilbur says, Charlotte is very brutal and she doesn't know how she's going to be kind and loving with her brutal nature, which is interesting because E.B. White didn't minimize that.
That's true. That's true. Now, what about Wilbur? Tell us about Wilbur's character.
Wilbur is very young. You know, he was born, like, you know, at the beginning of the play. And so he's shoved into the world without knowing much of it. And one of the first people that he meets is Charlotte. And he connects with her. And because they both have their problems and their ups and their downs, but they're still able to be together and, you know, be like a son and a mom and have a good time. Yeah.
Well, and I feel like the best part about this play is the fact that it is good for the entire family. Yes. Everyone will enjoy. When is this play going to be going on? How much are tickets? And what else can people expect from the play?
We open Friday. Okay. So we've got a 7 o'clock performance Friday. We've got two performances on Saturday. Okay. One at 2 o'clock and one at 7. And then another performance on Sunday at 2. And then the following weekend, the 16th, 17th, and 18th, the same schedule.
Okay.
Tickets are only $10, so they're good. It's easy for you to bring the whole family. It's at Luca.
Okay.
It runs a little over an hour, so it's good for even younger children who can't sit still terribly long time.
Yes, of course.
It's a great introduction to theater for a young audience member, and we really are very proud of what we've put together and very excited to get it in front of people and really hope the community receives it and comes to see it and learns to love it the way we do.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like everyone loves Charlotte's Web. It's such a classic. Yeah, I remember reading it when I was a kid, and it has such good lessons kind of intertwined in this wonderful story. Anything else you guys want to add about your characters or why people should come on out?
I just think it's a great first theater opportunity for children. I think it's a really good family outing. So
okay. It is, yeah. We have a very diverse cast. This is like my 9th show that I've done, and I'm 16 myself, and I hope to be, you know, doing theater in college. But anyway, the point is it's a very diverse cast. It's a very good show. So
okay, wonderful. Yeah. If people want to buy tickets, do they need to buy them ahead of time, or can they buy them at the door? And where do they buy those tickets?
They can buy them at the door.
Okay.
The box office will open at 6 or 1, respectively, an hour ahead of curtain time. Or you can contact Will of the Wind through willofthewind.org. You can send us an email or the telephone number 241-7778.
Okay, perfect. And is there any sort of intermission, food, beverage, anything like that?
There is no intermission because it only runs about an hour. We do have a snack bar set up.
Wonderful.
So there will be snacks for everyone and some water, and we try to create the easiest environment for the community as we can. I just want to add, you know, the great thing about a diverse cast is it truly reflects the diversity of the Barnyard. The Barnyard's a great place to represent the world overall.
Yes.
And how we've got all these different animals that have all these different ideas, all these different backgrounds, and they come together and they live together and they accept each other for their shortcomings, and they help each other to see that Wilbur survives. It's a great little story. You won't be sorry.
Well, make sure to go out and see it. It is going to be a wonderful production. Thank you guys so much for joining us today. And of course, coming up next, everything you need to know about Lubbock Meals on Wheels, Easy as Pie fundraiser. That's next.